the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese. Hello, Alice. We're Chinese Pod. I'm Jenny.
And I'm Ken.
Well, we are playing a universal game today.
I don't know if this is a universal game. I think this may be a universal game, but I know where it came from.
Where?
China.
Oh.
It's got to be China.
Really?
I really think so.
So it's 石头剪刀布 we're playing today.
Otherwise known as paper, scissors, rock.
Not in that particular order in Chinese,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. That's interesting. In fact, there are some other differences.
Yes.
But am I right in assuming that it's a Chinese game? I think it is.
Probably, I don't know.
My assumption is that it is. And if anybody out there knows better, please do inform.
Yeah, please enlighten us.
Now, there's also a second little point about it. In English, we say paper, scissors, rock. But in Chinese, you don't say paper. You have a...
布.
布, meaning...
布. Cloth.
A piece of cloth.
对.
So there you go. Anyway, now we're going to repeat this a lot to get the rhythm of the language. The one more point I want to make about this, from a tonal perspective, I find this really useful, this lesson, because there's all sorts of interesting combinations of tones.
Yes.
Very natural. It's not contrived. It's very natural. And I personally find that these tone combinations are useful. So.
对, 石头剪刀布.
Yeah.
石头剪刀布.
Yeah.
There's a beautiful rhythm to it.
That's right. But some of the other stuff too. So anyway, but concentrate on meaning first and let's say the structures later. So let's listen
好.
To it three times.
对话, 第一遍。
你洗碗?
你洗?
那我们石头剪刀布。
好。 石头剪刀布。
再来。
石头剪刀布。 你输了, 你洗碗。
第二遍。
你洗碗?
你洗?
那我们石头剪刀布?
好。 石头剪刀布。
再来。
石头剪刀布。 你输了, 你洗碗。
第三遍。
你洗碗?
你洗?
那我们石头剪刀布?
好。 石头剪刀布。
再来。
石头剪刀布。 你输了, 你洗碗。
Okay.
Now translations.
Yes, Let's... and I think we'll do the translation just one time here because there's a lot of repetition.
Okay. 好的. 你洗碗.
You wash the dishes.
你洗.
You wash.
那我们石头剪刀布.
All right, well, we'll do the rock, paper, scissors.
好, 石头剪刀布.
All right, we'll do the paper, scissors, rock.
再来, 石头剪刀布.
Again, rock, scissors, paper.
你输了, 你洗碗.
You lose. You have to wash the dishes.
Yeah. Slightly confusing between the Chinese and the English.
Yeah, a little bit. But a lot of interesting stuff here. Now, again, the game, I've heard everybody call it different terms.
Yes.
You know, paper, scissors, rock, rock, paper, scissors, whatever.
Anyway, just those three things.
That's it. Those, you know what, the three elements. So now, let's take it from the top, right? Because there's some really interesting tonal stuff here in the first couple of sentences, too.
对,你洗碗。 你洗碗.
你洗碗.
Talking now, about doing dishes.
Doing dishes. So the word for dishes is?
碗.
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 That sounds very much like a third tone.
You are right.
Okay. And to wash is?
洗. 洗.
洗. Is that another third?
Yes, correct.
Now let's put them together.
洗碗. 洗碗.
洗碗.
Yes. So the first third tone becomes almost like a second tone.
It kind of does, doesn't it? 洗碗.
洗碗.
Yeah, 洗碗. Now, not to be confused with the verb to like, which is
喜欢. 喜欢.
Just make sure you get that, the contrast there. So one more time, to wash dishes is
洗碗.
洗碗。
洗碗。
Yes.
Now, just for added, just to make your life more difficult, we put in the pronoun for you, and that's a third tone normally, and so we say,
你洗碗。你洗碗。
你洗碗。
Yes. So the way to approach this is 洗碗 itself、
yes.
is a word.
Yes.
So sort of separate from the 你。
Yes.
Do 你 first.
Yes.
And then 洗碗。
Good.
你洗碗。
你洗碗。
对。你洗碗。
你洗碗。
嗯。
Whoa.
Yeah. And that sounds like an order almost.
It is. That's an imperative. It's literally you wash dishes.
Yes.
Well, that's not something I would ever utter in my house, I can assure you.
But in this dialogue, the husband and wife are quite playful.
I think it's a playful dialogue, right? Because the husband says,
你洗,你洗。
You wash. Now, obviously, we know the 洗 refers to 洗碗。
洗碗, to wash dishes.
So look how efficient this is, you know? It's like, you wash.
你洗。
You don't even need an object. You wash. Obviously, it means the dishes. Let's hear those two sentences again, Jenny, because they're tonally sort of important.
你洗碗。你洗碗。你洗。你洗。
There you go.
Yes.
Okay, and so what was the response there?
那我们石头剪刀布。那我们石头剪刀布。
So, 那我们 basically mean, well, in that case, we will...
石头剪刀布。
Now, tell us about these three words, Jenny. The first one is...
石头。石头。
Now, literally meaning...
Rock.
Rock.
Or stone.
Stone or rock. It's the same. The tones are...
Second and neutral.
Second and neutral.
Yes.
石头。
石头。And then scissors. 剪刀。剪刀。刀
剪刀
对 third and first.
Third and first, scissors. And the last one is?
布布
And 布 means cloth. So in Chinese we say stone, scissors, cloth.
Yes.
In English I find people use differently. Paper, rock, scissors, whatever changes.
Whatever. Scissor, paper, rock.
Or something. I've heard of them. Whatever.
石头剪刀布
Good. So here's the music of it here. Let's hear that again, please.
石头剪刀布石头剪刀布
So that's a good way to remember it. Okay.
Because it has such a beautiful and flowing rhythm, that's why when we actually play the game, we always say it loud.
As you're doing it with your hand, you're going,
石头剪刀布石头剪刀布
There you go.
And incidentally, Kay and I were really doing it.
And I lost both times. There you go. You know, obviously, you're going, oh, well, come on, let's do it again. You say,
再来
再来
石头剪刀布 And notice just now we said 那我们石头剪刀布
Yeah
And we didn't have a verb
That's right
You don't need a
verb You don't need it Just say we 再来 mean do it again
是的
Okay Now to win and to lose in this case you just lost
你输了你输了
你输了
对输 First tone means to lose.
You've just lost. 你输了。Pretty much any sort of table or board game as well, you could use it. You say,
输了。
输了。
或者 any sports game, 输了。
你输了。
对。
So, therefore, you have to wash the dishes.
洗碗。
洗碗。
你洗碗。
你洗碗。The horror of it all.Anyway.
I always volunteer to 洗碗.
You do?
Oh, I love 洗碗.
You love 洗碗.
It's very therapeutic.
Is it?
I love the action of cleaning off the grease.
Wow. That is truly interesting. Say no more.
好的.
There's a great Janie Ju quote for you, ladies and gentlemen.
That washing dishes is therapeutic.
Woohoo! Anyway, let's listen to that three more times, shall we?
Okay.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons. Get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
对话第一遍
你洗碗
你洗
那我们石头剪刀布
好石头剪刀布
再来
石头剪刀布你输了你洗碗
第二遍
你洗碗
你洗
那我们石头剪刀布
好
石头剪刀布再来
石头剪刀布你输了你洗碗
第三遍
你洗碗
你洗
那我们石头剪刀布
好石头剪刀布
再来
石头剪刀布你输了你洗碗
Okay, so I think there was culture there and lots of little language things. I like the patterns. I think the patterns are good. Always listen for rhythmic patterns to remember tone combinations and so on. Now, what you should do, of course, is follow up with this. Go to ChinesePod.com and explore, make connections, follow your own route, and always staying, of course, connected to the community of practitioners and other learners and other resources, but always... being sort of master of your own learning, as it were. Now, we will be back again tomorrow.
We love being here.
We certainly do. Well, where else would we be?
But we also have a life outside the studio.
We do. We have to go and...
对, to get back to the other life.
Well, life out of the studio means going to prepare more lessons, basically. But that's what we love doing. And we'll be back again tomorrow with another lesson. But in the meantime, it's time to say...
再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
0960.
So just go to www.chinesepod.com/0960 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/0960.